Hello everyone and welcome back guys to a brand new video where today we're here finally returning with F1 My Team Season 5. Yes, potentially the last season we do here on F1 2020 with our standard My Team career mode. But that doesn't mean as we head to Australia for pre-season testing that things are any less exciting. Some big transfer news coming in straight away with 212 Motorsport, their third different second driver in 3 years. Is that seat cursed? Is the big question that a lot of people are asking. But it is going to be Max Verstappen who fills the second slot at 212 Motorsport. Some of you guys thought he was leaked at the end of the last season. Others of you, I would have thought, realised that I was well aware it was going to be featured in that video. It was a little bit of a teaser for you guys ready for Season 5. But yeah, Max Verstappen then joins 212 Motorsport, still in the hunt for his very first Formula 1 World Championship. But bigger news comes with Max Verstappen joining the team, and that is a new engine supplier. Yes, Renault and our relationship really fell apart towards the end of last season. Now, Hamilton wasn't happy with them. He was very, very vocal about that. And so we have gone to Honda Power. Yes, quite an interesting change-up, I'll be honest. But Red Bull were not in a position of power to really go against it. Obviously, AlphaTauri certainly weren't able to as well. And that was always the big thing as to why we weren't able to get Mercedes or Ferrari power. So yeah, we are now going to be Honda-powered 212 Motorsport ready for Season 5. They love Max Verstappen. Hopefully they'll love us just as much as well. And they honestly believe they can give us an engine that can deliver. We've seen some brilliant results coming from AlphaTauri thanks to the power unit upgrades that Honda made over the course of last season. So our first ever championship without Renault. Things might start out a little bit rocky, but we have got high aspirations and hopes for the season ahead. Obviously, myself, I want to try and become a four-time Formula One World Champion, match the highs that Sebastian Vettel was able to achieve during his dominant run in the early 2010s. There, a decade, obviously, before this 212 Motorsport team came into Formula One. But of course, that doesn't mean, obviously, we're out of driver transfer news. The only big team to hold on to their driver lineup from last season was Mercedes. Yes, obviously Valtteri Bottas and George Russell there, obviously with Hamilton leaving 212 Motorsport. There was some interest from Mercedes to try and get him back, but they almost felt betrayed by Lewis Hamilton come the end of last season there. So they've stuck with their lineup of Bottas and George Russell there. They're hoping, obviously, when 212 Motorsports transfer over to Honda Power Unit, so they can try and get in front early on and really try to hold on to a championship lead. Whether, obviously, we'll see that come from Mercedes is a very different question. But they have really been the only team that's ever stood any sort of chance against 212 Motorsport. They have dragged the championships out a whole lot more in the likes of Season 2 and Season 4. And coming into Season 5, still look obviously like a very, very good team, and certainly one that is capable of winning world championships. You know, they want to get back on the top step of the Formula 1 tree. You know, they've won 7 championships in a row. 2021, obviously, Season 2 of this career mode was a very, very big change-up for them. So they're hoping that obviously after a couple of years of sort of sitting for settling for second best, that they can really come back and get to the top of the Formula 1 world once again. Obviously, George Russell and Valtteri Bottas had up and down seasons last year. They certainly both felt like they didn't quite maximise the car and they didn't quite take every opportunity that they possibly could. But still, strong signs for the future in front of them as well. And maybe, just maybe, Season 5 can, of course, be the year that they finally put an end to 212 Motorsport's dominance in the world of Formula 1. Hamilton, though, has gone to Red Bull ready for Season 5. A crazy, crazy swap coming in for the new championship. But yeah, Hamilton has gone to the Red Bull outfit ready for the new season. After Daniel Ricciardo's announcement of retirement midway through last year, Red Bull were desperate to get a top talent once again back in the team. Alex Albon had a good season. There were some ups and downs, I think that can be said, for the entirety of the Red Bull squad, who started Season 4 with so much promise. 2 wins early on in the championship. Then after about round 5 of the season, they really fell away from Mercedes and 212 Motorsport at the top of the championship there. They did, of course, hold on to a very, very safe P3 at the end of the season. But Christian Horner was sort of left wondering what went wrong. Why on earth weren't they able to keep up with Mercedes and 212 Motorsport's development race over the course of the championship? But yeah, a 7-time world champion in Lewis Hamilton paired with a young, feisty Alex Albon is certainly going to make an interesting lineup ready for Season 5. You know, they need to look at the strengths they had from last season. They were able to get a race win back on the board for the first time in 3 years. But certainly, Red Bull, yeah, trying to look forward rather than looking into the past. The last, though, crazy, crazy driver transfer news coming in for Season 5, obviously, of course, was the fact that with Daniel Ricciardo leaving, Verstappen going to 212 Motorsport, Ferrari were left scrambling a bit last minute trying to get a second driver in, and they've actually picked up Guan Yu Zhou. Yes, China finally has made its mark in the Formula 1 world. I cannot even begin to imagine just how many Ferrari t-shirts are going to be sold in the Chinese market over the course of this year. But yeah, Guan Yu Zhou joins Ferrari. The first time, I think, in Formula 1 history, Ferrari has picked up a rookie to kick off their F1 campaign. Crazy, crazy times ahead for the young Chinese driver, and he really has been chucked in at the deep end here. There was honestly a lot of speculation as to whether Ferrari might pick up Nick De Vries, Kevin Magnussen from Haas, or maybe, of course, one of the young drivers from Alfa Romeo, obviously Jordan King or Matsushita. But there was no intent from Ferrari. They couldn't get another big name in driver in from one of the bigger teams as well. So yeah, again, they were sort of a bit left scrambling, but Guan Yu Zhou, yes, certainly appreciates the opportunity. And whether he end up seeing him in Ferrari for Season 6, obviously if Season 6 does go ahead, is a very, very different question. But certainly a driver lineup that I recommend you guys keep your eye out on over the course of the season. Season 4 wasn't a good year for Ferrari, though, but hopefully Season 5 is a whole lot better. Of course, then, with the announcement of Red Bull's Daniel Ricciardo leaving, AlphaTauri's drivers Danny Kvyat and Pierre Gasly both thought this was finally their chance to get the seat back at Red Bull. But no, once again, AlphaTauri keep hold of their lineup from 2019, if I'm not mistaken, as well there. So yeah, a very, very gutted Pierre Gasly and Danny Kvyat. But AlphaTauri made big, big strides over the course of last season, finishing fifth place overall, only 2 points behind Ferrari at the season's end. Pierre Gasly had a brilliant string of form in the later rounds of the championship. So AlphaTauri, you know, they're targeting P4 this year. Hopefully they can finish best of the rest and really see if they can try and challenge for more podiums in the world of Formula 1. An incredible outfit with a lot of talent behind them as one, and obviously with those Honda power units, now with three teams obviously using them, they're hoping that Honda can make even bigger strides forward. They can learn from Red Bull and, of course, 212 Motorsport now at the front of the field as to what they're going to be able to achieve next. And yeah, P4 is the target. Gasly wants to try and score more podiums. Danny Kvyat really wants to prove himself as a big match for Pierre once again as well. But yeah, both drivers a bit gutted not to get the call up nonetheless. McLaren as well retain their lineup, which, if I'm not mistaken, is now the longest standing lineup in this career mode there. Lando Norris and Carlos Sainz with McLaren now in 2025 after originally both being hired in 2019. Before this series even began, if I'm not mistaken, it is just those guys and AlphaTauri that have kept their lineups since the very beginning. A bit of a rough season for McLaren. They did just lose out to AlphaTauri at the end of season 4 there. They were really, really close between those guys and Ferrari as well there. So there was a big, big chance of P4, and unfortunately they just dropped the ball towards the end of the season. But looking into season 5 though, McLaren still trying to make forward progress, forward momentum with their Formula 1 car as well. You know, they've sort of definitely solidified themselves as a strong midfield runner, but they just need to unlock that little bit more, obviously, if they want to be fighting towards the front of Formula 1 again. You know, it's not right seeing McLaren constantly finish in the midfield still. And yeah, hopefully those guys are going to see a bit of a resurgence of form over the entirety of season 5. But yeah, P4 is the aim for McLaren once again. One of the biggest disappointments, though, I think, over the course of season 4, of course, was Racing Point. A really, really quiet season. Very rarely were they able to pick up big points at the end of the championship, and are a long way off that battle for P4 come the end of the season. They're 7th place for Racing Point. They didn't even break 100 points at the end of the year. And considering this was an outfit that had won Grand Prix just 2 seasons prior, yeah, Lance Stroll and Sergio Perez really not happy with the balance of the car throughout the entirety of the season. They just never felt they were able to gel with it, and therefore never were really able to get those big driver results as well. They were a long way ahead of the 4 teams behind them, though, which obviously we'll get into in just a minute. But yeah, Racing Point, you know, they know this season is about rebuilding. Once again, you know, they are well aware they want to try and get a bit closer to McLaren, AlphaTauri, and maybe Ferrari, obviously, depending on what those guys are able to achieve. And maybe if they could sneak sort of P6, P5 at the end of the year as well, they said that would be a brilliant, brilliant bonus. Obviously, a lot of big backing going into Racing Point behind the scenes as well. So whether obviously we're going to see some forward momentum and a progress from those guys, I think we all hope. We always like to see the Pink Panthers fighting towards the front of the field then. And without a doubt, I think the biggest disappointment from Season 4, of course, has to be Renault. They had a brilliant run of form during Season 3. Obviously, Esteban Ocon gets some brilliant results there. Kimi Raikkonen, I'll be honest, I'm not too sure why they've continued to hire him in towards 2025 there. Kimi, bless him, he's a good Formula 1 driver, but he's just too old at this point to really be trying to battle it out with the younger drivers in Formula 1. Esteban Ocon very much being the main contributor to that team's lineup at the moment. And yeah, 34 points, 8th place in the Drivers' World Constructors' World Championship. Sorry, they're only ahead of, obviously, Haas, Williams and Alfa Romeo at the rear of the field there. Renault, they need a resurgence. They need a bit of a cash injection as well, and especially after losing 212 Motorsports engines ready for the new year as well. Yeah, Renault really not in a good place right now in the world of Formula 1. But there's always a chance for a resurgence. We've seen it before from Renault. They have made big steps forward from one season to the next. So maybe, just maybe, Season 5 is going to be their year where they hopefully can battle it out once again with the midfield. They very much were a team that would just pick up a few points here and there, obviously, if it all went wrong for the other teams around them. But anyway, moving though into the bottom three. Of course, first up is Haas Formula 1 team. Again, another team that really just fell backwards over the course of the year. They scored a couple of points early on in the championship, obviously Monza being a big opportunity for all three of the backmarker teams there, and obviously Haas once again were able to capitalise on that just with a small car advantage. But after that, yeah, Haas really, it very much looks like these bottom three teams trading places at the rear of the field week in, week out, but I would not be surprised if none of them were able to score points over the course of Season 5. You know, they desperately, again, just like Renault, need a cash injection. Magnussen and De Vries, once again, though, at the helm, so Haskell, I don't think it's the drivers that are the cause of the problems with the team at the moment. But yeah, desperately want to make forward progress, but struggling to see light at the end of the tunnel is Haas Formula 1 team at the moment. Maybe, just maybe, they can find, you know, a bit of a loophole in the regulations and maybe, yeah, just find a little bit more pace and performance. The other big news, though, of course, was Williams finally scoring points during Season 4 of this career mode there. Their first time they've scored points since 2019. Williams able to pick up 2 points at the Italian GP courtesy of Antonio Giovinazzi. Latifi once again in the team, bringing obviously those huge piles of cash with him as well. They're obviously hence why he's able to keep his lineup with Williams there. And obviously Giovinazzi, a good friend of the Canadian as well. They're once again back with Williams for another season. Obviously major news though from Williams over the last few years, but they finally seem to be settling back down again, and they're really hoping, although there's not too much optimism, they're really hoping that they can try and find a little bit more performance and maybe, just maybe, try and sneak a couple more points finishes over the course of the championship. Obviously, the big difference between finishing 10th and 11th overall has really, really helped the team out over the course of the winter break. Maybe, just maybe, they can sort of see themselves as a bit better than the Haas this year, get a couple of better results, and yeah, try and finish 9th overall at the end of the championship as well there. But of course, that leaves our final team then ready for Season 5. It is Alfa Romeo once again. A torrid season last year, just never had the pace. Got a bit unlucky obviously at the Italian Grand Prix, their home race as well. The fact that obviously Haas and Williams were both able to get points on the board, but Matsushita and Jordan King both really, really struggled to give the team the information that they needed with the car as well, which really just felt for Alfa Romeo that they couldn't make any forward progress over the course of last season there. But again, the thing is, obviously, with these backmarker three teams is whoever can seem to get, you know, that best result, get that lucky race point here or there is really, really going to make the difference come the end of the season. So, obviously, Jordan King and Matsushita both going to be trying to take any sort of opportunity they can over the course of Season 5. But there we are then, guys. Some big, big news coming in for the new season. Obviously, some major driver transfers at Ferrari, Red Bull, and 212 Motorsport as well. Obviously, Verstappen joining ourselves, Hamilton to Red Bull, and then Guan Yu Zhou to Ferrari. There is certainly going to be a lot to watch over the course of Season 5. If you are new around here, make sure you do leave a like and get yourself subscribed as well. We're trying to hit 15,000 subscribers on the channel at the moment, so if you can help me get one step closer to that, that would be greatly, greatly appreciated as well. But yeah, we will be back tomorrow, ready for round one of the season. Let's get this thing going here from Albert Park, Australia. I can tell you guys now, you do not want to miss it. A big thank you to our channel members for making these videos possible. You can be featured in these end clips as well as granted access to some other exclusive perks for just £1 a month by clicking the join button below.